Yo. Hey. No, you.
Oh,
hey, Ronnie.
Hey, Lou.
You are. What the hell are you doing over there?
You're way over there.
What? This is weird.
Yeah.
Welcome to another episode of Men Are So Smart. I'm Lou Gallagher.
We are.
And you?
I'm Corbett Ryan. Oh, thank sorry. You. I forgot.
Yeah, that's when you jump in. Okay. And today we are at Stingray's Marina in beautiful Knights Landing.
Yes.
And we are having a good time. And we're going to meet Keith and Susan next on the next episode of Men Are So Smart. And hello, once again, welcome to another episode of Men Are So Smart. I'm Lou Gallagher.
I'm Corbett Ronnie.
And joining us today on our show, live from Stingray's Marina in beautiful Knights Landing, California, right on the Sacramento River.
Historic Knights Landing.
Indeed.
I saw a sign coming in.
I saw the sign as well. And we have Keith and Susan with us today. And in the magic bus, say hi, everybody.
Hello.
Maximus, hi, how are you guys doing? Nice to be here.
Hi.
And this is Joel here.
Okay.
And that's my wife, Bonnie.
All right.
Historic.
Oh, historic. Yeah.
Historic Bonnie.
And that's Olivia.
All right.
There's Olivia over there.
We are here today because this is a great place to be on a Sacramento summer night. Here we are on the second day of summer of 2018. And Ronnie and I are joined by Keith and Susan, who have been nice enough to host us tonight and allow us to come out and do our show. You guys, tell us what brought you to this particular property and why we have a Stingray's Marina. Keith?
Yikes, it goes back 18 years this year. And I had an opportunity through a family friend that owned and operated it for years and years, and saw that the bar business was changing and that it really needed to become a destination. And he was aware of my special event production company that allowed me to do themed parties and special events up and down the state of California, and felt that I was the best one. People tried to buy him out for years, but he thought for it to become a destination, with my background in props and decor, that I could bring to it, and a work in progress, a labor of love. Here we are today with all the fun things that you've seen. And the bus is just the crazy thing that it became such an iconic aspect of Stingray.
And that brings us to shooting our show right in front of it.
Yes, yeah.
Ronnie, when we saw that, I showed him a picture when I was out here with you guys the other night. I sent him a picture, and he goes, oh, we've got a broadcast room in that bus.
Right.
That's the first thing he said.
Yes.
And I said, well, it's not actually a whole bus. It's kind of a sliver of a bus.
It looks like a whole bus.
Yeah, it does, from the front. Yeah. And what's the story with the significance of the flowers on the front there?
Well, that's actually just a picture frame that we had a group of people come up and had a special event here that we hosted. And next thing you know, they went on to go on to, after their event, to other destinations. And lo and behold, hanging off the mirror is that picture frame.
Awesome.
So it works like this.
Wow.
Can you unhook that?
So beautiful. Yeah.
This is a live show.
Here we go. Yeah, so live show.
Oh.
So this is what the idea of the frame is.
It's a nice frame.
I love it. That's great. So, Susan, coming up on June the 30th, you have the Big River Band out here.
Big River.
Now, you just had a very successful night with Blues Situation with Emerson Crusoe, and I want to thank everybody that came out and saw that show. What can you tell us about Big Blues Band?
Big River. Richard John is Keith knows them more than I do, actually, but they're a favorite out here. People love them. They're awesome country rock, and they're a great group of guys. They're coming out, and people love them. They're bringing a big crowd and nice guys. And Richard John's also a Marine, like Keith, so.
Brother.
Just real excited to have
you. Got that Semper Fi thing.
Yes.
Semper Fi. Service. Sure. Now, when folks come out, what is it that you most want? How do you want to show them a good time, guys?
The argument is, it's family friendly, pet friendly. We don't serve hard alcohol. We want people to come and enjoy themselves and recreate on the back of the bank of the Sacramento River. We don't charge a cover. We recognize, and with the economy and the gas prices going up, we work really hard to keep it fun, clean, safe, and bottom line for this summer season, affordable.
Now, you grew up in this area, Keith, you were telling me, and as a kid, I'm sorry, Susan, I'll kick you.
You keep kicking me.
You were telling me that in the Yolo County area and surrounding area, there wasn't a lot to do when you were growing up. It was cruising, of course, you were telling me, but there weren't a lot of destinations. And so that's how you came up with the idea of promoting this place.
Well, it was really frustrating to, it was a different world when we graduated high school in 1976 for me, 75 for Susie. And we were able to cruise Main Street. We had the drive-in restaurants. We had the bowling alley. We were able to go out in the country and four-wheel drive. And it was just a real simple lifestyle. And the times have changed dramatically. Now the kids can't be on Main Street. It's illegal to cruise. Where do you go for fun? Summer fun. And it's just still, after all this time, they were able to maintain the opening of the bowling alley, but that's about it, unless you want to go catch a movie. It's even illegal to park in the parking lots like we used to and cruise up and down. It's illegal to cruise if you drive down Woodland Main Street. So we're trying to create an environment that's family friendly, all ages, don't have to worry about the hard alcohol aspect. We're, 15 minutes max from Main Street, Woodland? And we look at how nice it is.
Oh, we are enjoying a beautiful sunset on the river. The only thing that's really missing tonight is a little Delta breeze, which I understand
nice.
You guys get ready early on.
We live or die by the Delta breeze.
I think, too, it's a nice place for women to come where they can feel safe. I think that was very important, have a place where women can come and they don't have to come with a man to be safe. It's a comfortable, everyone welcomes you. Children, you can bring your children, you can camp here, you can bring in an RV, you can, like our friends, and people just feel very safe and welcome and warm.
And you've got so much going on here. You've got a boat ramp, so folks can cruise up in their boat.
Camp here. Technically the dock, okay, so across the river.
Oh, dock, I'm sorry, I said ramp.
Yeah. Technically, across the river from us, Yolo County Parks and Recreation operates the boat launching facility, and we have the docking facility here at our place. So it's fun to be able to say you can literally go anywhere in the world from our dock right here in Knight's Landing.
Yeah.
All you got to do is head down the river, and it's the Sacramento from Shasta all the way to the Golden Gate. And whether you go straight to Hawaii, hang a right and go to Alaska, or hang a left and go to Mexico and the South America, you can literally go anywhere in the world from our dock.
We've got to get us a boat, Ron. We've got to get a boat. That's what we need.
So we got people that jet ski up here from Sacramento that bring their boats. You can overnight tied up to the dock. You can anchor out, bring a tent, sleep in your back of your pickup, or bring an RV. We can accommodate everybody.
Now, from what I understand, in the past, you've done food trucks out here.
Oh, yeah.
But you have a barbecue going on now. Tell us about that.
Some of both, you know. I'm a little frustrated that the more popular that we become, how much time I got to stand behind the barbecue. Shout out to those guys that want to make the name for themselves.
Yeah.
I'd like to have a barbecue king right here making him handy. Juan comes up with the taco shop from Woodland on the weekends and our special events, does a great job, takes the pressure off of me from cooking burger after burger.
Yeah.
So
I still want your burgers because they're good.
Oh, yeah, yeah. But
I saw you sprinkling some seasoning on those.
Yeah, they're good burgers.
All right, so let's see. Some events that are coming up in the month of July. Maybe you can tell us about those.
I've got to look at my calendar. We have a Ripper Rots reunion coming up. and I haven't put the July calendar out yet, but we have a two-piece band, Carol and Guy, who will be singing during that river rap. That's a potluck, and people are welcome to come out, share their stories of the river. We also have,
Carol's, who we want to make a real argument for what we do with our artists that perform on the stage here. Good old boys, local talent, been performing music for decades. And Carol Stone is one of those that reflects that. Her and her husband will be out here. She sang with all the local woodland bands, Little Hud, Cherry Cherry, Rocky and the Rebelettes. Oh, yeah. I mean, on and on. You recognize the names. And so her and her husband are coming out here to perform, you know, and they'll be out here more often. And it's just what we'd like to do with the big stage here is, one, it's hard to find a venue that offers live entertainment. And then it's frustrating for us because there's so many bands and so little time. So we try to give everybody a chance on it, on the big stage performing here. But then when we get a band like Big River, local favorites, and that's what she says, Richard Johns. If people know Richard, lives right here across the river from us in Knight's Landing. He grew up performing, even his dad and himself, and now with the Big River band, with Harvey Brown and the Sidewinders. And that's a longtime local name.
Yeah.
So that's the kind of good old boys that play good old music. And we bring down a lot of musicians from Marysville, Yuba City, Yuba Sutter, great network of musicians up that way. And boy, I tell you, it gets real frustrating that we don't have more time to run more entertainment. And the guys are all, you know, it's what I call more talent than ego. These are personalities, local people that, like us, love what they're doing.
So, Susan, do you actually book the bands?
I do. Keith is helping me, but I'm learning.
All right. So, how do people get a hold of you specifically if they'd like to put out?
I'm on Facebook. Through Stingrays, they can message us, and I will contact them and give us. They will give me their available dates, and I'll look at our calendar at what dates we have available, and we'll work together. And so Stingrays is the best, or Susan Hagel. They can message me directly on Facebook.
Okay. And you guys are at Stingrays Marina on Facebook, right?
We are, yes, Stingrays with a Z on Facebook. And there's also our website, which is the www.stingrays.us.
What do you say? We've got a rather large audience that watches the show on a regular basis. What would you guys like to say to our audience about Stingrays Marina? Invite them out.
I'm going to let you take that.
Well, it's almost frustrating in the sense that 18 consecutive years of being here, and I talk to a lot of my friends, and they're like, well, we don't tell our friends because, like, this is our secret place. We just don't want you guys getting big and popular so that, because we like it just the way it is. And then the frustration of food and beverage, the only way you can make any money to reinvest in your property to make it bigger and better is you gotta do volume.
Yeah.
So we're always trying to balance that. How much do we do? How much can we do? And we wanna make sure that every guest that comes here enjoys and experiences what we want them to. I call it laid back. Laid back in a shaka, a Hawaiian, you know. I was lucky enough to live in the Caribbean, visit the islands and the Hawaiian islands and charter sailboats and just knock around. And in Jamaica, it's called Soon Come. In Hawaii, it's called Shaka. It's called Aloha. And you just want that spirit of friendliness to be the overwhelming factor when you experience in this kind of environment that we created. And yet there's the business side of it, and I've got to make a buck so I can pay the bills. Yeah. So the next time you come back here, it's even better. So it's just a balance, and we just want people to be able to experience that here. If you're looking for fast food, hey, McDonald's is down the road.
Right.
If you're looking for a nice experience, you want to have one of the best burgers you can find, come up here. You want to hear some good music and without having to cost you an arm and a leg to be able to sit down and enjoy it, come see the guys we put on the stage.
Yeah, that's what you were telling me, is that many of these guys are original artists, and they do cover tunes too, but you know, most music that you see out here, or a lot of it, I should say, is original music. You're not going to see anywhere else.
Yeah.
All right, it's very easy to find. I know you're saying, well, Knight's Landing, oh my gosh, where is that? Look, here's how you get it. You take I-5 north to Woodland, and you exit at County Road 102, and you just follow that. It takes you all the way to Knight's Landing. You cross the bridge. Just as you come over the bridge, you'll see the signs for Stingray's Marina. Very easy to get to, as I said, on Facebook, at Stingray's Marina. That's Stingray's, STINGRAYZ, marina.com. We are thrilled to have you guys aboard as a sponsor of our show. We do appreciate it. As I told you, we like to live up to what we say we're going to do, so I hope that we did that tonight. And thank you very much for having us out here. We appreciate it.
Thank you, guys. Success with your show. Yep. Thank you for extending the spirit of aloha, and what, as they say in the Hawaiian Islands, ohana.
Yep.
These people came here as strangers,
awesome.
Became family,
awesome.
Ohana.
Yes, Joe,
it's wonderful to be here. I've run into some of the nicest people here. Everybody's so friendly. It's not like going to a typical bar scene where everybody's kind of just into themselves. And this was just, I was sitting out here reading our material beforehand, and a couple of people just came up and asked if I needed anything. It's very nice, yeah. They're probably wondering, what the heck is this guy doing out here?
Yeah. I had to text them and let them know that you were coming. I forgot about that.
Some random guy is parked in the parking lot.
Well, you did show up awfully early, Ron.
Yeah, I had to drop my wife off at the bus stop.
Oh, is that what you call it?
It was a pleasure trip for me, yes.
Ah, I see. All right, that's going to wrap it up here from Stingray's Marina. We got to get out of here. You'll find all of the information on either Ronnie or I below, including our social media, links to that. Our website is menaresosmart.com. Our blogs are there. And our show comes out Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at 9 a.m. Pacific and noon on the East Coast, on the right coast.
Yes.
That's what I like more, on the right coast, not the left coast. All right, my name is Lou Gallagher.
I'm Corbett Ronnie.
And we'll see you folks on the next Men Are So Smart. Everybody,
yay.
Everybody, aloha.
Aloha.